when a heart attack happens, one cell, you know, the heart cell, when it dies, all other nearby cells, no, there is a signal they send across and they tell to the mother cell, oh, our brother is dying. And instantly the mother cell will send an impulse to all the nearby cells, go and help him. Which means what they do, the dying cell, they will come and they will fill that space. That is where sometimes, you know, from a heart attack, many people will be saved if they are not tampered with, because the heart is self-regenerative. It can regenerate. Many people who try to interrupt in that process might go through. And let me tell you one more thing. Some people who have gone through a heart attack, and this is not me, this is medical science saying, people who have gone through a heart attack and who have recovered, you know, by the time before they get to a hospital and before they have been touched by any doctor, they will lead a very healthy life afterwards. It is not that little, because they will have, you know, that heart has already self-healed. But many a times, you know, doctors will start putting certain things because it is dying and they interfere. That might sometimes not work. Many a times the person will die if it is not administered. I'm not saying medical help is necessary. It is essential, very, very essential. Medical help has to. But those people who have survived before the medical attention was given to them from a heart attack, that means their heart has become healthier now.
Okay.
Because of all the nearby. Similar philosophy in planets. We are trying to help each other. So the fifth lord and the ninth lord, always the other planets will try to help in some way or the other. They are saying, oh, you are good for him. Let me help you. And he in turn will say, okay, I'm ready to help other people also. Give me an opportunity to do it.
And one last thing I would like to maybe add or ask you, like, so for example, as you said, for Ketu, so somebody suppose is born in a Venus ruled nakshatra or Jupiter, so then apart from the thing where is it placed, that planet, but in general, if you see, like, for example, somebody is born in Purvashada, for example, that's ruled by Venus, so then we can always say that, you know, the those Venusian things, like, you know, like marriage or love, romance, they will always be an important
that way. And whichever houses Venus rules,
exactly,
from the ascendant, let us say, for example, Gemini ascendant, as you said, moon in Purvashada, so for that native, first you see where Venus is placed. If Venus is, let us say, it is placed in Aquarius.
Okay.
So Venus rules the fifth house and the 12th house. Twelfth lord and fifth lord, right? For Gemini ascendant. So definitely Venus will have something to do with the fifth bhava and the 12th bhava attributes will be played. Then it will definitely give some results related to the ninth house. It will also give the results of the 11th house. Because it is Aquarius, the natural 11th.
Okay. Very interesting.
So without that, you don't even look at a chart. If you don't put the basis of Kala Purush Kundali, many of the secrets are not being seen. Then you look at the nakshatra.
Yeah.
First you have to see, you know, see, basically you're looking at a filter and behind the filter there is real thing. But filter, what it is saying.
Exactly.
Red film or something which is there. What are you seeing through that film? It is a filter, a red filter, blue filter. So that is what I'm trying to say. You look at that. Then you go into nakshatra and then you do the other things what we have already discussed. That is a simple thing. But first you have to understand why is that person soul born. Mahadasha Lord is going to give you a very significant clue. That is why our ancients have given so much of emphasis on to moon nakshatra. Moon nakshatra anyway is important. That I'll tell you, you know, that is very, very important, no doubt. But the Mahadasha Lord, where it is sitting and what is the clue it is giving you, it will give you many clues of the purpose of the life pattern in broader canvas, what is activated in this life.
Yeah, and the dasas will, you know, dynamically change or, you know, like try to move the course accordingly.
Correct. That's true.
And that is what I also feel. I have in my experience, like suppose somebody is born in a Venus nakshatra, no, or Ketu rule nakshatra. So Then now the Mahadasha will be over, of course, when they are born very quickly.
Yeah.
Even if the Mahadasha is over, I have seen when the Antardasha of that particular planet comes. You
know, yeah, definitely.
Events happen in their life.
Yes, definitely. You see.
Yeah.
Give some significant events also. Sometimes, you know, something which is transformative.
Exactly. And sometimes I have seen, like, I met one person. I asked him, give me some prominent events of your life. And then he said, you know, oh, actually, when I was very small, this thing happened, you know, that thing happened. So he has not mentioned dates, like, you know, he got first in a big 10th class or something. Now, generally, people will mention those things, right? That I got stood first in my college. But later on in the consultation, he was telling me that he stood first. Then I asked him that, why did you not write this in the mail? So then he said, but I did not feel that was like a big thing, you know. But certain small things which you have mentioned, I have seen they were in the Antardasha of that Mahadasha Lord in which he was born. So maybe that is something which you feel very much, you know, even if externally it may not manifest.
Yeah,
out it may not. You will feel it internally very much. I have seen that.
Definitely. But one more rider which I forgot, maybe, you know, just to add, don't forget the Badakesh.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Badakesh means Badakadipati, which means it's an obstacle creator. Okay. So if the obstacle creator, you know, the principles of Badaka, right?
Yes.
So for all, you know, Chara Rashis, movable signs, the 11th house becomes the Badaka. For all Sthira Rashi or fixed signs, then the 9th house becomes the Badaka. The 9th house and the 9th lord. And for all dual signs, the 7th from them, we will become the Badakesh. So what nakshatra that Badakesh is sitting will also show you some major blocks in that house, in the chart, and what planet it is ruling also, that also will be somewhere it is. If it is sitting with the Mahadasha Lord at birth, then it is giving you a lot of problems during that time when you're born.
Oh, okay.
See, simply, I'll tell you one more secret, which, you know, is.
In fact, I was supposed to ask you this question. If those, you know, the Mahadasha Lord and the Badakesh is related, then what happens?
Then it is a problem. Yeah. But which means you are doing everything right. Other, you know, nakshatras will help you to overcome.
Yes,
but there will be struggles and strifes and challenges to overcome.
Oh, okay.
So the another secret is any planet which comes into Aquarius will give you some problem related to at least one problem related to the Karaka of the planet.
Okay.
Because it is the natural Badaka house.
Okay, interesting.
Or the Kala Purush Kundali.
Correct.
For Aries, Aquarius becomes. So Saturn is also the Badakesh. So that in Kala Purush Kundali, so Saturn is always dreaded because of that.
Saturn because and Rahu is, both.
Yeah, Saturn and Rahu both. Now you get the understanding why Saturn and Rahu is the most dreaded.
Exactly.
It's because the Badakesh of the Kala Purush Kundali. Kala Purush means the cosmic man, which is Aries becoming his head and Pisces becoming his feet. Never do any Jyotish without looking at the Kala Purush Kundali. This is something I'm giving you. You will get great insights by keeping this in your backdrop and reading every Kundali, your own Kundali. Because ultimately, what is the golden reference? The golden reference is the Kala Purush Kundali.
Yes.
It is the, you know, the natural zodiac is the golden reference. On top of that, you are putting your chart. But never forget, whatever results that the golden reference has to give, it will give in your chart.
So in fact, I have seen to some extent, even when planets are in Scorpio, this happens, I have seen, apart from it.
That's also true. Why? Mars and Ketu.
Yes. And they are also the Karakas for surgery.
Exactly. And accidents. And occult. Major planets coming into Scorpio and Aquarius can also give you a yoke for becoming good astrologer. Of course, there are other things also. I'm saying sun is important. You know, moon is important. But I'm just saying for lunar-based astrology, like nakshatras, moon becomes important. But I'm just saying major planets congregating in Aquarius and Scorpio, in general, I'm saying they will give better. There could be hundreds of other combinations that you have to look at. Exactly. So I'm saying in general, as a thumb rule, because it is the house of research, Scorpio.
Yeah, correct.
Okay. So Scorpio, whatever you know, it is the sediments. Whatever is sitting, it is getting stirred. It is because still water. No? When in still water, what happens? All your karmic sediments have gone and settled down. So somebody will come and stir that water. And all the sediments will start coming up to the surface.
Okay.
It is the still water with all your karmic sediments at the bottom. So a catalyst will come. That is where you say, you know, I don't know, this guy came into my life, this person came into my life, and suddenly my life became, you know, went haywire. I don't know what happened. Because he is the catalyst or she is the catalyst. They'll come and stir the pot.
Okay, all and the what, karma will be coming out.
Karma will come to the top.
Okay. And if you cannot handle it, then you say, my life is bad after meeting this person.
Exactly. Correct. Isn't it? Anyway, anything else?
In fact, regarding this Kalpurush you have said, now I have also seen this, like generally if planets are, you know, like for example, they say Mars is debilitated in Cancer, you know, but whichever house Mars is in, if it is in Cancer, you will always get that feeling, you know, that softness. Because Cancer is originally the fourth house, you know.
Yeah. Then with the same concept, don't forget. Same concept, don't forget. This is something I'm giving as an extra tip for all those people. And this was given by a great astrologer, late Mr. S.K. Mehta from Delhi. He's written only two books, but he has seen, observed this over thousands and thousands of charts over his career as a professional astrologer. He was brilliant, apparently. And what he used to say is, if one planet is debilitated, then it will feel the same in the trine houses. For example, moon gets debilitated in which Rashi?
Scorpio.
And that means moon will feel debilitated in different sense, even in Pisces as well as in Cancer. Moon house also, because moon is getting debilitated in a watery sign.
Oh, okay. Power, fantastic this.
Even if it is the same house, you see people who have Cancer moon, no? They will be highly emotional and very indecisive. Although yes, you say it's the same house, right? Indecisive means a bus comes, they will say, oh, the bus is full. Should I climb this bus? No, yes, no, yes, no. The bus is gone. One more bus will come. They will say, okay, I'll take the next bus. After 15 minutes, again, this bus is looking a little bit filled. Should I take? But you already decided you have to be at point B somewhere. By the time you just go, the bus will start moving and then you will have to get down like that. No, it is always giving you a fickleness.
Okay, so now for exaltation also in the trine. So for example, moon gets exalted in Taurus. Yes. So in yes. Capricorn and Virgo, it is.
So sun will feel powerful in fiery signs because sun gets exalted in Aries.
Because the tattva is the same, I guess.
Tattva is the same. Well, ultimately, the planet is feeling happy because of the tattva.
Exactly.
So this was his research. And I've seen his brilliantly working. Many things. Now, if I add the nakshatra layer to it, na, I'm getting very, very fine granular results. Because now I know exactly, you know, what is that tattva and where is the debilitation effect. See, there is nothing to say with debilitation and exaltation. All I want to say to you is nothing that means debilitation means it is bad. And one more thing I want to clear is debilitation means a point 1 degree on either side of that point, it becomes debilitated. Many people, just because it is moon is sitting in Scorpio, they will just randomly say this moon is debilitated.
Correct.
Unless it's sitting around 3 degrees of Scorpio, don't say it is debilitated.
Exactly.
It is approaching the debilitation. See, there is a thing. One is it is approaching the debilitation point, then it is getting weaker. It is going into khadda. Khadda means it is fall.
Yes.
But if it has crossed that, which means more than 3 degrees of Scorpio, moon has gone, then he has crossed that point of challenge. But 2 degrees, it is approaching that point. So that will be, you know, weak. 2 degrees of Scorpio will be weak. That will be considered as something which is that the planet will struggle. But in today's time, don't get worried with debilitation, because in most people who are successful, at least one or two planets have to be debilitated in Kali Yuga. Because that area of your life, you're going to put maximum effort to help that planet be successful. So don't mean to say that, you know, exaltation point is good, because exaltation point, if it is very close to an exaltation point, then at least one karakatva of the Mula Trikona and the house it represents, it will destroy. At least one.
Okay.
So for, if Jupiter is, you know, around 5 degrees, if it is exalted in somebody's chart, you know, 4 degrees also being considered, 6 degrees can also be considered. So if it is even, you know, 3 degrees, it is approaching the exaltation.
Exaltation.
When it is going very close to exaltation, then one signification of that person's chart, Sagittarius, whichever house it is representing, at least one signification, it will mar or become malefic. So in that sense, don't you think, you know, debilitation is much better than actually speaking about exaltation?
Yeah, and this I've said many times in my videos, you know, exaltation is like a degree of awareness that is very high, and debilitation. Exactly. Yeah.
Because of awareness being high in some area, there will be in the head office of that planet, one area you will not pay attention to.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Because the awareness is very high. Because you think you are a great pandit. Because Jupiter is, you know, gets exalted in Brihaspati's nakshatra. Intelligence, scholarly, and thinking, self-proclaimed geniuses.
Yes.
Because they think they know, na, some area of their Sagittarius, wherever from their lagna, whichever house Sagittarius is, one signification will be you're not paying attention to, it will suffer.
Yeah. Fantastic.
Okay, Babaji, I think we have spent too much of time today. I know, yeah. I've taken, this is not your usual thing. Maybe you will release this as many parts. I don't know. Maybe 10 parts or whatever. So, you know, people have only very small, limited time period they can grasp things. So you have to keep that in boost.
Yes, yes.
Keep I will, that people will be, you know.
I will upload it once I edit it nicely. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Babaji. And you
also have a channel and you have your app and website. Everybody knows, but if somebody still doesn't know, then you can just type his name. He's all over the place in YouTube. You'll find him. And yes, I would like to give special credits to Amanji for arranging this meeting. I mean, I wish he was also here, but maybe next time.
Thank you very much, Babaji, for having me on your channel. It's a pleasure to come here and share some, you know, thoughts. These are some random thoughts, but I hope the viewers are going to take this seriously. And my only intention is look at astrology from a perspective of self-correction, not as prediction. Okay. Don't go into the prediction mode. Look at self-correction. And I think this technique will help you to correct, you know, many areas where I think karmically, you'll be able to progress. Materialistically also you'll be able to progress, because you're addressing those areas where the focus has to be, the energies have to be, because these are the pillars. You know, 1, 4, 7, 10 are the pillars of your chart. If the pillars are weak, then your whole structure is weak. So the beams of your house has to be strong for this foundation to be strong. So have these things, you know, and pay attention to those areas of your life and to those nakshatras. And love those nakshatras, love those planets, every planet. You know, the more love you give, I think you can see that manifest definitely in your life.
Fantastic. Pearls of wisdom from you.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you very much for so much of your time all day.
Yeah. Namaste.
Okay then. Namaste. Thank you very much. See you.